Welcome to Excel Magic Trick number 1221. Hey, if you want to download the source book 1221 to 1223, click on the link below the video. Hey, in this video, we have a daily meter reading change table. So the date, the meter reading, and here's the change. Now, I simply want to chart this. So I'm going to highlight the field name at the top of the date column and all of the dates. Then I'm going to hold the Control key, click the Change field name, and then all of that column. Now I've isolated two columns, and I can chart it. Insert. And up in the Chart group, I'm going to click on the Column chart and click Clustered Column, which is our 2D. And lo and behold, look at that. And that's what this question said. They're saying, what do I do about that one minus? Now, these zeros are OK, but the minus. Now, let's look at this formula. It's simply taking whatever today's reading is minus the previous. So of course, when we get down to here, it's 0 minus that. No problem. We can fix this chart almost instantly by changing the formula. Really, when we get down here, we don't want the formula to calculate. But up here, where we have some meter readings, we want the formula to calculate. So in cell C3, I'm going to hit the F2 key. Now notice, our goal is to either put the formula into the cell or down here to show nothing. So anytime you put one of two things into a cell, you can use the if function. Now the if function has three arguments. And the first one is a logical test that comes out true or false. Well, look. That has a number, I want the formula. That has a number, I want the formula. That has a number, I want the formula. That cell does not have a number, so I don't want the formula to calculate. So the logical test, and by the way, that formula right there, if I type a comma, we're actually going to put that into the next argument, value of true. That's the thing to put in the cell if our logical test comes out true. But here's the logical test. And in English, we just look over there and say, hey, is that a number? But guess what? There's an isNumber function in Excel. And that value, we simply click on the relative cell reference 1 to my left. I have to close that function off with the closed parentheses. And that's it. That isNumber will give us a true or false. When it sees numbers, it's true, 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 true. When it doesn't see a number, it's false, 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 false. So that brings us to the rest of the if function. The value if true, that's the thing we're putting in the cell if it's a number. Now we come to the end, comma, to get to the next argument. Value if false is the thing we want to put in the cell, like down here, if there's not a number. Now the way that you show nothing in Excel is you put a double quote and then a second double quote. That's the syntax for show nothing. Now it technically is something. It's a zero length text string. That just means it's considered text with zero length. But it's the syntax to show nothing, so that will work. And watch this, close parentheses, Control Enter. And now I'm going to double click to bring that edited formula all the way down. And instantly, our chart is working. No more negative number, no more zeros. And watch, as soon as we enter 1039, that was the meter reading on 8/5/2015 when I hit Tab. Instantly, the if function now sees it's a number, so it puts the formula in the cell. And sure enough, boom. Now I'm going to fix this chart up a little bit. I don't like these gaps here. The charting engine is trying to be polite. It sees dates, which are serial numbers, so it tries to put all of them. I'm going to click on the axis and either right-click Format Axis down at the bottom or Control 1 to open up the task pane that we use in 2013 and later. Now, under the series here, the axis options, it says axis type. Watch this. I'm going to click text axis. And instantly, it's treating them as if they were text values instead of numbers. And it no longer shows us any missing numbers, right? Because it went from Friday to Monday. And it was trying to be polite by putting Saturday and Sunday. So there we have it. Now, actually, let me do one other thing. I'm going to click on the axis. I'm going to change the gap width just a little bit. I definitely want a gap between there, but I'm going to leave it like whatever. I like that one there. And then I'm going to come over to the Fill bucket. And under Fill, I'm going to select Vary Colors by Point. And I might even come down to Border, select Solid Line, and then down here I'm going to select like black outline. Now I can close this and look at my chart. That's looking pretty good. I don't like that title there. So instead of clicking and typing, I clicked on the outside. I see that solid line. I'm going to type an equal sign, just like I was making a formula. And look at this. An equal sign appears in the formula bar. And since I have my title right in cell E1, I select that and then hit Enter. Daily meter reading. Now I can come down here. The next one is 1050 tab. And instantly, I get my column. Now, this is one way to solve this problem. And if we didn't like all these extra labels out here and we wanted these to automatically add as we add new records here, we could use the Excel table feature. Now, I'm going to highlight and copy just this top low part with our formula, Control-C, and then scroll down, let's say, A25 and Control-V. Now we have the starts of our table, and we simply want to add records below here and have the chart update. Well, there's the Excel table feature. As long as you have field names at the top and records in rows, we can convert this to an Excel table, which has dynamic ranges. Dynamic range simply means add new records, and any formulas, pivot tables, or charts that are pointing to this table will automatically update. So I have a single cell somewhere in my table selected. Insert table, or I can use the keyboard Control-T. It guesses the range right because I have empty cells all the way around. My table has headers or field names. Click OK. Now, we can simply chart. I'm going to click in date and drag all the way down. Hold Control, click the change field name and all the way down. Now I go up to Insert, and I have my column, clustered column. Now, let's just see before we even fix this chart up, let's see what happens when I click in the last cell in the last record in our table and hit the Tab key. I'm going to type 8/5, Tab, 1039, and Tab. The actual table feature copied the formula down, and it added a new column height and label for our chart. Now, let's fix this chart up. I'm going to click on the top cell, equal sign, scroll up, click in the cell E1 and Enter. Scroll down, click on the axis, Control-1, select Text. Come over to the fill. Notice this is not what I want because the axis is still selected, but I can, with the task pane open, click on any element in the chart as soon as I click on the columns. Now I see my fill for the columns, vary colors. Border, click Close. Wow, that's cool. Let's try this again. Now, I clicked in the last cell, and if I use Tab, it adds a new records. But you can simply start typing directly below the table, 8/6, Tab. And this is 8043, Tab. And sure enough, the record is added. The formula copies down. Absolutely beautiful. So that is one way to chart daily meter readings, either with the Excel table feature, which automatically, as you add new records, copies the formula down and updates our chart. Or we can simply, if we have an established set of dates, we can simply use an if with an is number and that double quote for show nothing, and instantly our chart will update. All right, we'll see you next trick.